Hello, I'm Bill Gormont with Motivational Vision. Thanks so much for joining me on another edition of Successful Journeys. Today we're going to be looking into the process of change. We'll be understanding how that process actually works during transitions. Change is very difficult for a lot of people. In fact, change is difficult for most people. In many cases, it's because they just don't understand the anatomy of change, how it works, why it works, and why some people react the way they do. So let's take a look at this in terms of the movement of change from the present, today, into the future, whatever that future may be. As it moves forward, we understand that at the beginning, there is an ending. Anytime there's change, something has to end for something to have to begin. And as that occurs, those people that the very beginning, sometimes there's some paralysis that sets in. There's avoidance and there's certainly frustration because they really enjoyed things the way they were. Then you end up into a transition, the first transitional point where at this point you try to find a way out. You try to regain control. Again, not the easiest for most people. You end up in the middle. In the middle, it's sort of a neutral zone, a person without a country, a person without relationships. This is the final realization of the inevitable. Things are going to change. It's important during this point to be able to make peace with it and internalize that future, whatever that future may be. As you begin to move into the last phase of this, people begin to finally find their way forward. As they do, they understand where they were. They understand that, you know what, this might not be so bad. They begin to embrace the good, and they start to find that bad, you know what, it isn't quite as bad as they anticipated that it actually might be. And then you have the beginning of the future. At this point, people are starting to become comfortable. They're starting to let the former go. They're enjoying the good, and they're feeling the value in the bad. They understand where it was, and you know what we thought wasn't going to be so good is actually okay. And I'm so glad that I made this transition. The situation is that not everybody is at the same place at the same time. There are some people that move quickly, others not so much. When you look at a typical staff distribution, and I don't care if this is a small organization, if it's a major company, if it's a service organization, honestly, it just doesn't matter. A typical distribution during change looks like this. You have a lot of people that are excited and they begin to move quickly. Others, it's not so much. And as they make that life change, and in many cases it actually is that, this is what you'll see. Not everybody moving together at the same time. Those people sitting over here that made that change quickly, you know, they now start to take a look at what happened. And there are some people that aren't moving, and they begin to get a little frustrated with this. And it's important for the leader to be able to reach out to those people that may be still in the ending stage on that left-hand side and begin to make some changes. Those people that are in the transitional stage, you know, a little slower than perhaps those on the right, but they'll eventually get there. You have these people, sometimes groupthink plays into this, and when someone within their small group, within their small cohort, when one person says, you know what, this doesn't seem to be so bad, I think I'm going to give it a try, others invariably will follow. But there are some that are dyed in the wool and deep into the trenches, and they're there because of the paralysis, because of the avoidance and the frustration that they have. Those people that moved quickly, you know, those who are impatient, they're adaptive, they're innovators, they want to get going. They know there's going to be change. They're excited about the future. So with that, they hop on board quickly. And sometimes they look and they say, I don't get it. I am really so frustrated. Why won't these people change? There are some people here in this organization, apparently they're not team players. I guess there's nothing I should be doing with them. I'm just going to move forward by myself. You know, maybe we'll leave them behind. Those people that aren't adaptive innovators, that maybe are not so impatient, they're over here saying, you know what, I have always done it this way, and I'm not changing. I'm not changing today or tomorrow, period. That's it. And then there's you. Then there's the leader. And you're sitting here in the middle of this. You're the transition team. And the transition team, at this point now, you've got those that want to move, those that don't want to move, and you have to say, whoa, hold it. Let's begin to talk about this. The process of change really boils down into two pieces, and they are very specific, they are very distinct, they are very separate, and each one's really important. The first, you have the physical shift, the external. That's the first piece to change. You know, you get a new job, perhaps you go to bed one night and you and your partner are just a couple, but in the morning, you're parents. You have the relocation of either a home or perhaps even of a business. Then you have the psychological transition. It's an internal transition. You know, what's necessary to come to terms with this new situation? What do I have to do? So you have the physical shift, the external, and you have that psychological transition sitting in the middle. We would call that the internal. And moving from the present to the future, and please make no mistake about that. If there's anything you take away from this session today, please understand that moving from the present to the future requires a physical shift and a psychological transition. And if you have that psychological transition not occurring, movement from present to future, it just won't happen. So the process of change, everybody's going to get there. It just takes some people a little longer than it does others. Give those people that are a little slow on this transitional journey, give them the gift of time. And the best way to do that is to help them understand what's in it for them. That's everyone's really favorite radio station, WIIFM, what's in it for me? When they begin to identify how they will benefit, how the skills they have can be used in this new world, when they begin to understand the benefit that they bring to this new change by them participating in it, all of a sudden, they begin to find value in their participation, and that bad, that frightening new world, it doesn't seem so bad because they have their role identified in it. They've been able to see a connection with their skill set, their excitement for being able to bring that to the team to move forward. So that's really the process of change. It's understanding that there is a physical, there is a psychological, the two have to play together. And it's important for the leader to understand that not everybody is going to move at the same time in the same way. With that said, the one thing that you can do is to, number one, understand it. Number two, have patience with it. Number three, reach out to those people who are slower on moving forward. Let them see the role that they play. Again, thanks for joining me today. I'm Bill Gormont. This has been Successful Journeys, and I look forward to seeing you again really soon. Thank you so much.